Hello everyone. I hope you all are doing well. Welcome to our YouTube channel, The Engineering Projects. In today's tutorial, we will have a look at how to increase the EF core performance for multiple entities, and for that, I will be using a third-party Nuget package designed by SaveChanges. Link is given in the description of this YouTube video. We will post multiple videos in this series where we will discuss other CRUD operations, but today we will only focus on saving data in the database. But before going into that detail, let's first have a look at the output, so that you could get an idea what kind of increase in performance we can achieve using this extension library of SaveChanges. I have designed this project in ASP.NET Core. Let's run this project first. As you can see here, I have placed these two buttons on the home page. Both of these buttons are saving 5,000 entries in our underlying database, but they are using different methods to perform this task. The first button will use the default SaveChanges method of EF Core, while the second button will be using the extension method BulkSaveChanges. Both buttons are performing the same task of saving 5,000 entities in SQL database. I will explain the code in the second half of this video. For now, let's look at the difference. Let's see how much time these two methods will take for saving an equal amount of data. Let's first click on the SaveChanges button, which is using the default SaveChanges method of EF Core, called on the instance of DB context class. I am not fast forwarding this video so that you could also feel the time difference. As you can see here, it's taking around 25 seconds to save 5,000 entries. Now, we need to restart our .NET application to remove the cache. Let's run it again and now click this second button. I will demonstrate it in a minute, how to add this method in our application, which is using the extension method BulkSaveChanges, and this method is also called on the same instance of DB context class. As you can see here, BulkSaveChanges method has taken around 10 seconds for saving 5,000 entities, for which SaveChanges method has taken 25 seconds. So, there's a clear difference in the performance of these two methods. BulkSaveChanges is 2 to 3 times faster than SaveChanges method. Now let's quickly have a look at why EF Core performs slow for bulk data. EF Core is an object relational mapper, and is used as a bridge between ASP.NET Core application and its database. Thanks to EF Core, now there's no need to write complex SQL queries for database-related operations. Instead, developers can easily perform all database CRUD operations in C# language. When multiple entities are saved using EF Core, it doesn't save them in a single SQL session. Instead, it takes multiple round trips to the database, which increases the overall time for the data saving process. In a professional .NET application development, there come many scenarios where the developer needs to save multiple entities in the database, for example user notifications, real-time messages, friend requests, etc. And if you are using EF Core for such tasks, then you are compromising on your application's speed. In order to overcome this performance issue of EF Core, many .NET developers and companies have created extension libraries, which are available as Nuget packages. I have tried many of them, and the one which gave me the best results is this one, named z.entityframework.extensions.efcore. It's an extension library of EF Core, designed by SaveChanges. We just need to install its Nuget package in our application, and all its functions will become available, and can be used from the instance of DB context class. As I said earlier, we will only discuss the BulkSaveChanges method in today's video, but let's have a quick look at other methods this EF extension library offers. So, other than BulkSaveChanges method, it also offers BulkInsert. It's an upgraded version of BulkSaveChanges and gives even better results, as it is specifically optimized for adding multiple entities. Another method it offers is BulkUpdate. It's used for updating multiple entities in the database. Next we have BulkDelete. As the name suggests, it's used for deleting bulk entities from the database. Then we have bulk merge and bulk synchronize. Apart from these bulk methods, it also offers few batch methods. So if you are using link queries to access the database, then use these methods to improve the performance. First one is update from query, used to update database. Insert from query, used to insert data, and delete from query for deleting multiple data. Finally, we have few utility methods, for example, bulk read, where bulk contains delete by key. I have mentioned a few of them, and you can get the complete list from its official page. Link is given in the description of this YouTube video. Now let's design that comparison project from scratch in ASP.NET Core and see how to use this bulk save changes method in our .NET application. So let's open the Visual Studio software. Here I am clicking on Create a New Project. From these options, I am going to select ASP.NET Core Web Application. Click Next. Let's name it Bulk Save Changes TEP and click Create. As we need to create an MVC application, so I am selecting Web Application Model View Controller and again clicking on Create. As I have already designed this project, so to save time, I am going to copy paste the code and will explain it. You can download the project from our blog post, link is given in the description of this video. We have successfully created our new project in Visual Studio. First, let's run it to check if everything's fine. Yeah, it's loading fine. Let's stop the debugging. First of all, we need to install EFCore Nuget packages as we want to work with a database in our application. So right-click on the solution. And then click on Manage Nuget Packages for Solution. And here we need to install Microsoft.Entity Framework Core. Tick here and then click Install. Next, we need to install Microsoft.Entity Framework Core.SQL Server. Already ticked, so click Install. I agree. If we click on Installed, we can see the SQL Server package has installed. We need to perform migration. So we have to install Microsoft.Entity Framework Core.Tools package. Click on Install. I agree. Let's check the installed packages, and yeah, we have successfully installed these three packages. First of all, we need to create the object. So in the models folder, I am creating a new object. And let's give it a name subjects. And click on add. In this subjects class, I am placing these 50 properties from subject 1 to subject 50. The first one is key property ID. We need to create the AppDBContext class. So add new item and give it a name AppDBContext. Click add. First, let's inherit it from DBContext class and place this code where I am just calling the constructor and then created the DBSet property of our subjects class. Let's remove these errors by bringing in the required namespaces. I couldn't find the subject namespace. Oh, I have mistakenly created subjects. So let's rename it from subjects to subject. Click yes and now everything's working fine. Next, we need to create a repository. So in the models folder, add new item. I am giving it a name subject repository. Click add. It's a best practice to use interfaces for your repositories, so I subject repository. Click add. In the subject repository, Let's create an AppDB context field and have given it a name context. Now let's paste a simple function add1. This function will take the list of subjects. AddRange method will attach the collection of entities to the context object. And SaveChanges method will save these 5,000 entities. As you can see in the function, I have placed a stopwatch function just around the SaveChanges method, so that we could calculate how much time this default method of EFCore will take for saving multiple entities, and in our case it will be 5,000. And this method will return the time taken in milliseconds. Now, let's open its interface. Here we need to change the class keyword to interface, and let's add the definition of add1 function here. We need to inherit it from the interface. Standard.net stuff. Now let's open our startup file. And here we need to link our repository to its interface. And I am using add transient here. We also need to add the DB string in the startup file. Let's first save it in app settings file, so open it and paste this DB code here. Now let's come back to our startup file. And here this one line of code for configuring DB string. Let's add the SQL server namespace. Everything's ready, so now we need to run the migration commands to actually create our database and subjects table. So, click on View, Other Windows, and then Package Manager Console. Here let's run add migration command, which will create the migration, update database, Now let's open SQL Server Management Tool to check our newly created table. Click Connect. Let's open the Home Controller and remove all these extra methods. And here I have placed this method data to add, where I have created a new list of subjects, and in this list I have added 5,000 subjects with the help of for loop, and simply return this list of subjects. So, this function is simply providing us a list of 5,000 items. We will save these items in our DB. In the constructor, let's inject our repository using dependency injection. Now let's add another method here, addData1, which will first execute DataToAdd method and get the list of subjects, which has 5,000 entries in it. And then we'll send this list to repository method, add1, which will save this list in the underlying SQL database using SaveChanges. Finally, this method will redirect a home, so let's change our index function so if homepage gets the value of id, it will add it in the view bag. Now, let's open the index view page and paste this code here. It's a simple HTML code where I have created a form and added two buttons in it. The first button SaveChanges is calling the addData1 method of HomeController, which will save 5,000 entries in RDB. The second button is using addData2 method, which we haven't created yet, so it won't work for now. Moreover, I have displayed the time in milliseconds, taken from the view bag. Now let's run our application. And click on SaveChanges method. So as we have seen at the start, again it has taken around 25 seconds to save the data. And we can also check this data in the Management Studio. Let's clear the table. So far, we haven't seen anything new. We just saved 5,000 entities using default SaveChanges method of EFCore. Now, let's install a new Nuget package, which I have mentioned in the start, named z.entityframework.extensions.efcore. So, in Nuget library, make a search for z.entityFramework and you will get these results. All these Nuget packages are designed by SaveChanges, and as you can see they got downloads in millions, and here we need to install this second one. Tick here and then click install. I accept. So, we have successfully installed this NuGet package, and it will automatically add new function to our AppDB context object. Let's have a look at it in action. I have added this new method add2 in our repository, which is quite the same as add1, but in the second method, I am using BulkSaveChanges method instead of SaveChanges. This BulkSaveChanges is an extension method, comes with that newly added ZNuget package. Let's add its definition in the interface. Now run the application. And click on the second button. As we have seen in the code, both buttons are saving 5,000 entities in the database, but here BulkSaveChanges is taking around 11 seconds, while EF Core has taken around 25 seconds. When we interact with the database for the first time, it always takes more time as compared to the next attempts, because Entity Framework Core needs to compile and cache the model, and thus next attempts take less time. So, let's try both of these methods for 3 times and have a look at the comparison between their performances. First, I am going to try SaveChanges and will update its performance values in the below table. I haven't deleted the last 5,000 entries added in the database, so now our database is not empty, and you will see the SaveChanges method is going to take even more time now. In the first attempt, it took around 33 seconds to save the data. Let's click it one more time. Last time it has taken around 25 seconds, but now taking 33 seconds, and it will keep on increasing as your database gets bulkier. In the second attempt, it took around 25.5 seconds to perform the same task. Let's try it one more time. And here it took 25 seconds in saving the same amount of data. Now let's restart our application and try the BulkSaveChanges method. In the first attempt, it has taken around 12.5 seconds. Now let's click it one more time. And here's our result, around 7 seconds. It took around 7 seconds for which the EF core has taken 25 seconds. Let's run it one last time. And here it took 7.5 seconds. So, there's a clear difference between these two methods. BulkSaveChanges is giving us 2 to 3 times better performance as compared to default SaveChanges method of EF core. You can download this complete project from our blog post. I have given all the links in the description of this YouTube video. I hope you guys will enjoy today's video. If you have any questions, please ask in the comments section. Take care. Bye.